Hello, you malty malt bar makers. Ralfy here, and thank you to Joe for the malt mention. And yes, I think you've probably guessed by now, malt mates, we're in location again. Yes, a little flurry of locations. Well, I do need to get out of the Manx bothy now and again and stretch my legs and go to warmer, cozier places with a far better selection of whiskies than I can find even in my humble little traditional bothy. And the reason we're here is quite simple. This is Ralfy Review 720 Extras. Now, cast your mind back. It wasn't that long ago when I put up Ralfy Review 720 that we were in Mike's malt bar. So basically, Mike was giving us a grand tour. Didn't take very long because his bar's not very big, but there's a lot in it. You could see that. And it's something that I'm sure you've thought about, is a little room, a spare room in your own home, or perhaps a corner of a larger room that you could put some modifications to, that you could create your personal ambient whiskey sipping space. And I'm going to give you some advice on how to go about doing that. I haven't really created my own malt bar as such, because the Manx bothy stands in quite successfully, although of course it does need a heating upgrade, but that's neither here nor there. I don't want to get too distracted in the Manx bothy. But I'm sure that when you think about a malt bar, it can be quite daunting considering the options. Where do you start? And the place to start is in a bar. A professional bar, a public bar. So here we are on location in the Bon Accord, my favourite haunt in Glasgow, where if I happen to be around town, I'm occasionally seen propping up the corner, sipping an IPA, nothing too heavy with alcohol, something about 3.5-4.2%, nice and crisp, some Amarillo and some Citra hops just to give it that little bit of zinginess, and of course, a few little malt whiskies. So, that's where you're going to start, with your whiskies. Choose a few, not necessarily just malts, you can include blended whiskies, and importantly, you could consider having other spirits as well, so that if you have visitors to your malt bar, you're able to give them options, so they don't feel intimidated by all your maltiness. Right. So you're starting in a professional bar, somewhere near you, somewhere that you like. What to do is examine it closely. Why do you like it? Is it the lighting? Is it the range of bottles and the shelves? Quite important that, the presentation of what you've got. Now, you don't need a lot of shelf space, but just make sure that it is nice and classy. So you could go down to recycling depot, you might take an old bookcase, something from an auction house ideally, something that you can maybe knock a few shelves out and it's very easily and cheaply transformed into your literally your whiskey presentation case, something like this, except an awful lot smaller. Fine. Now, the next thing you've got to consider is cozying your environment. You're going to be sitting there. You're going to be ensconced, so to speak, in your personal malt bar. So how do you make it cozy? Well, first and foremost, you need comfortable chairs. So be careful about the chairs you have and keep it in proportion to the space you've got. That's quite important. And then once you've done that, considering you will need a table, you'll need somewhere practical to sit your whiskies on, your beers, your ales, your whatevers, and a range of glasses, and a source of water, and a water jug. These start with the practicalities before you get more ambitious. Now, once you've got everything provisionally in place, play about with the location and situation of your furniture and furnishings in your malt bar before you take things any further with decoration and lighting. Now, I'll start with lighting first and foremost. You can have a brightly lit, blingy environment, but you might also like to consider going to the other side of lighting and have some candles, perhaps some paraffin lamps, just to tone the lighting down, because in doing so you create more of an atmospheric mood and a coziness. if you've got a fire, an open fire, you're near a fireplace, absolutely splendid, fantastic. It really, particularly in winter time, it really kind of brings the coziness alive. In absence of a fire, candles, a little cluster of candles will do the job very, very well. So basically consider something like your church candles, your religious candles, large candles that are going to burn a long time, and then put a bunch of them together, seven or eight, even nine of them. Ideally go for odd numbers rather than even numbers. And then just kind of sit these candles down, light them up, and then move them around so that when you're sitting in your comfy seat, you're getting the best view of the warmth from your candles without them being too intrusive, or whatever other lighting you may consider using. Now, the next thing is to consider your decor, your furnishings. Well, your fixtures, you've sorted your chairs, your tables, your little malt bar, and you've set the lighting up. And now for the furnishings. This is looking at the space in your wall. How do you fill that space? And this is where you can go onto eBay or visit your old curiosity shops, or even if you happen to be in a bar and you see some old posters, some advertising thing, or even a few coasters, some beer coasters, these tend to be freely available in bars. Just ask them, excuse me, can I have a few of these from a little mini malt bar? You'll generally find, if you've been a good customer and you've bought a few drinks, that the bar personnel are going to be quite amenable to that. Certainly, I know some folk will go for these beer pumps and things, but that really is entirely optional. You don't necessarily have to go for a full-scale minibar or mini pub bar. You can quite comfortably go for something that's just got a few bottles, four or five bottles. Frankly, malt mix, it's all you need. And then finally, once you get everything situated, you've got your lighting right, you've got your mood created, it's nice and cosy. If you're in a bigger room, you might even consider a few separation screens that you can easily get at a shop, or make up yourself from hardwood, and decorate some with some tapestries and some cloth over it. Don't go to too much expense. All this can be done very inexpensively and even cheaply and still be wonderfully effective. Now, at this point, what you're going to do is you're going to test it out. Sit there on your own with your whiskey. Don't even consider looking at your environment until you've had a few whiskies and a glass of water. And once you've an hour or so into your event, your inaugural christening of your malt bar event, then ask yourself that fundamental question. Does it work? Does my little mini malt bar really work for me? What do I need to adjust? What do I need to change? What do I need to remove? What do I need to add to this to make it personalized and comfortably bespoke and mine? At this point, you're going to have a grand opening. Now, you could invite one friend round, a good friend, that's all you need, just to share that malt moment with you in your little mini malt bar, or you could invite a group of folk. But always make sure, malt mates, that it's good company, the best of company. Because when you've got some good whiskies and other spirits, you're already in the presence of good company, so long as you respect the fact that you're there to enjoy a few wee malties, a few wee spirits, but not get pished. That's important. You can ruin it. As soon as you're actually overdoing it, you're ruining the purpose of your malt bar. So make sure you've got good company, which is going to kind of help generate the right atmosphere. And there you have it, malt mates. You have got your little personalized, bespoke, individual, customed, particular, specific, and most definitely your malt bar. Now, you've seen Mike's and you've seen the Bon Accord again. I think Mike's Malt Bar and the Bon Accord here in Glasgow and North Street should be quite enough to inspire you to see what you can achieve in making your malt moments maltier and more momentified. I'll leave it at that, malt mates. See you soon. I'll be back again with a cheap, available, blended whiskey for Ralphie Review 721. Bye-bye now.